is the easiest thing, because we're engaging our different senses. Like I said, it's kind of a, it's an active, sort of an interactive meditation. So we're actually engaging our senses. We're engaging our tongue, our sense of speech. We're engaging our ears. And that way it's a little bit easier for the mind. The mind is what they call the general of the senses. The mind is telling everybody else what to do. Oh, you want to go eat that? Oh, you want to go taste that? Or you want to go look at that? You know, it's kind of like telling us what to do. So if we start to grab the senses in the meditation practice, then it's much easier for the mind to actually rest, to actually just, you know, stay there with us, you know, so. They're kind of all individual mantras, or as one, it's Gopala, Govinda, Rama, Madhava. So the Gauranga lends itself well to like a breathing technique. So I want to introduce you guys to a little bit of a breathing technique. And so just, you can sit comfortably wherever you are. You can close your eyes, you can bend your legs, you know, you can sit up straight. Try to find a place where you can lengthen your spine a little bit. So you can just, you know, whatever it is. It doesn't have to be super straight, but it just allows you to breathe a little bit more, breathe easier. And go ahead and just close your eyes for a moment. Bring your awareness internally. And just notice really quickly how you're feeling right now. How your body feels, you know, if there's any distress, any discomfort, anything, noticing how your breath might feel, or just your mind. What are the thoughts that are coming in and out? And even just our attitude, you know, what kind of feelings we're having, what kind of mood or kind of emotions we're noticing, just being aware of those things. And then I invite you to start to take a little bit deeper inhale. In fact, if it's comfortable, place one hand on your chest and one hand on your belly. And I want you to focus on breathing into your belly first so you can feel your belly expand. And then let the chest breathe in. And then let the chest exhale and the belly exhale. So I'm kind of encouraging you to breathe into the belly first, and then let the breath move up and fill the chest. And then the chest falls down and the navel, kind of pulling the belly back to the spine, letting all the air out. Again, just breathing, letting the belly fill first, and then letting the breath move up into the chest. Attention just be on your breath, really noticing, watching the breath, watching and feeling the belly expand, feeling the chest rise, and then watching that opposite direction, the chest falls, and the belly comes back, just letting it all the air. A couple more breaths. And you might notice that as you do this, it begins to become a little bit more comfortable. You begin to breathe a little bit deeper. Now in just a moment, we'll inhale and say the mantra within the mind. And then as we exhale, we're gonna say the mantra out loud through the length of our exhalation. I can do one, and then you guys can join me on the second one if that's more comfortable, or you can join me on the first one if you're comfortable. Everyone go ahead and exhale all your air, and then we'll inhale together. Gauranga. And then inhaling, see the mantra within the mind, we'll say it out loud again together.
Gauranga.
Keep going with your breath.
seeing the mantra within the mind on the inhale and the exhale, resting on that sound vibration. For just another minute, and I want you to just notice how that made you feel. If it was easy to stay on the mantra, if you felt like it was easy to stay with that, if the mind was still moving around, and it's okay either way, but just noticing. It gets easier with practice, but these mantras have an intrinsically attractive value, which attracts the mind, begins to attract the heart. And so it becomes easier and easier to rest on these sound vibrations. And this is a really simple and a really potent technique you can use all the time. When you wake up in the morning, if you're ever experiencing, just some frustration, some anxiety, some, confusion, it's always good to step back out of the situation, take a couple of deep breaths, and utilize this Gauranga mantra. And then reapproach your situation, you'll notice that it just allows you to, and anytime we meditate, anything we take our mind out for a little bit, we get a little bit of a reset. It allows us to come back with a little bit more clarity. So if you haven't already, start to open your eyes and come back into the room. And just let me know what did you guys think about that? Was that easy? Was it hard? Was it different? Difficult?
It was a bit difficult. Personally, because I was thinking about the weather, and because my job is working at a horse stable, and thinking about the horses I let out, hoping that they were let in soon.
No, we always have so much going on. Mm-hmm. Anybody else? That's it.
I think I could hear in my head myself going and saying the mantra.
Mm-hmm. Good. Yeah. Yeah. Sometimes it's new, especially when the mantra's new to us. We're kind of like, am I saying it right? Is it the right sound? What is this? But it becomes this place where we can kind of rest. And that's the point in meditation, right? It's kind of to give ourselves a little bit of a rest. So sometimes when it's new, we're like, oh, I gotta think about it a lot. Or, maybe there's just a lot of other stuff going on, It depends how heavy those other stresses are, right? I'm really concerned about this or that. But that's okay. Anytime we practice meditation, it's not gonna be the same every time. And, it's not always easy. But having that a little bit of a regular practice, it gets easier and easier. We get to be able to, control the mind and let go a little bit more, each time. So that's a little bit of Gauranga breathing. It is something we already like, right? Music and hearing, and it has this vibration, right? That is just, you're sometimes very calming or just, kind of familiar, and feels good. So we utilize a little bit of sound vibration. So what this is called, it's called kirtan. And kirtan is, it's a call and response with these mantras. So I'm going to say or sing a mantra, and then you guys are going to sing it back. And don't worry about, it's not about your quality of your voice or what you sound like or if you're in the right keys, nothing like that. I want you to relax as much as possible in the sound. Hearing the sound, letting the sound come in the ears and hearing it when I sing it, and then saying it back. It's kind of this expression, and it's this exchange that we get with each other, so we get to have this exchange with each other. So I'm going to go over this one, but I'm just going to do like one word at a time, so we're not going to get too crazy here. So it'll be relatively simple. I might just go back and forth between some of these different words, but I'll do Gopala, and then you guys can do Gopala, and I'll do Govinda, Govinda Rama, and then I might do Madan Mohana in the same. And it's okay if you don't get it perfectly. It's not a stressful thing. Even just listening has a nice effect, you know, just again, just trying to take the mind and relax into the sound. There's nothing else we need to really worry about, so I'm just gonna try this and see how it is. See how you guys like it.
Thank you.
Yes, that was.
And there's always gonna be this, you know, the mind's always gonna wander. It's, and we're not ever gonna sit down and do meditation and it be like, oh, I did a perfect job. You know, like there's, and there is really is no, you know, perfect. It's just, you know, when we notice that and we go, oh, that was, that's something else, but you know, I'm just gonna, I'm doing this right now, you know, and I just wanna come back.
I found it incredibly